might be wondering right now, why am I starting a video in Venice, Italy, and not outside of Barcelona? Well, let me tell you why. This is not the normal intro to these chappy videos, and I'll get to the normal intro shortly, but I just want to let you know that a couple days ago, while I was in Carcassonne, France, my computer had a random weird reset with my SD card in it, and I lost a bunch of important footage for this chapter. And so most of the video of this chapter will not work together exactly the way that I want it to. Some parts aren't going to make sense. It's just going to transition to something like that randomly without me saying anything. So, forgive me. I am very upset that this happens. But here goes the very confusing yet exciting, hopefully, chapter 4. Welcome to chapter 4. We are in Maresa, Spain. And it is our day before the last day that we will be in this country. We've been here for 36 days in this country specifically. And I'm ready to get out of it. The opening shot was Nate and I cycling down Montserrat, just outside of Barcelona. And we're about 40 miles outside of Barcelona, and we are heading up to Andorra. But let me tell you really quick about our time in Barcelona, which was not documented. Within 12 hours of getting there, a few things happened. One, Nate's spoke broke again for the fourth time, twice, in the course of 3 minutes, which ended up causing him to just get a whole new rim. Then I met some really great English people, and we went out to go to a bar, and we ended up sitting outside on a terrace. And I'm not going to go into detail of exactly how this happened, but my phone got stolen. Gone. No more phone. And today my tripod broke because of the way that I was carrying it, and so now it's half the height that it used to be. And that's kind of a problem because I want to do some photography that might require it to be taller, but I don't know. But nonetheless, like what I said before, we're heading up to Andorra, and it's going to be brutal, it's going to be hard, it's going to be beautiful, but we're in this together. So, go ahead, sit back, relax, and enjoy the next 20 or so minutes of Chapter 4. Woo! Yeah, this is a dust. It's hot. I don't know if you can tell, but Nate and I are about to go through a tunnel. So we're on the side of the road because...
Ooh, come look at this. Look at that.
I have a flat.
Jonathan's bike, not mine, this time.
Sad day. Got that all patched up. Let's keep going.
Let's get out of here.
Andorra, 112 kilometers. We have stopped because we actually ran out of water. And so we came here to get más agua. Si, señorita?
Si. I'm pretty tired.
We have about 25 kilometers left to go until we get to our destination. We're 2,300 feet right now. That's all I have to say. It's exhausting. Just keep on moving. Just keep on swimming. You can see the Pyrenees off in the distance. I think Mercadona has officially been my favorite part of my day, any day that we go to one of these, because these things are just amazing. So we got dinner now and breakfast for tomorrow, because tomorrow's Sunday and everything is closed on Sunday, and tomorrow's going to probably be our hardest cycling day of the entire trip into the mountains. And there's no towns there either, so I'm actually kind of worried about our food situation, but we'll see what happens. I don't know if you can tell, but we're still going up a mountain, and we're at almost 3,000 feet. You might be able to tell by my face. Ooh. Like and subscribe. Okay, we made it up there. It was like 4 or 5 miles long. Brutal. Made that. Wow, today was hard. Tomorrow is going to be probably just as hard, if not harder, because it's the day we go to Andorra. One of the smallest countries in the world. Well, some people call it a country, it's just a sovereign state, you know, but nonetheless, it's still another spot I've been waiting to go to for years. I'm going to get there by bike. I don't even know the name of the town we're in. I think it's like Odiara, something like that. But it's right at the base of the Pyrenees mountain range. We got our tent site and everything here. So for those of you, for you couple of hundred that have stuck this far with me in on this trip since I've put these up, thank you. Let's go to the next day.
Honestly, I might just wear my red shirt again. It'd be better than this white shirt.
After like 41, 42 days, I don't even know what day it is. I've got to tell you, I have no idea how to start the day anymore with the video. Not original. But to you, I say good morning. We are in the town of Ogern, Spain. And hopefully this is the last day that I tell you that we're in Spain.
I like Spain.
I don't care. I don't. Oh, no, sorry. Okay. Woo. Woo. I do like Spain. Wow. Okay. Sorry, I did not mean to offend. I do like Spain. I've just been here for over a month. It's time to get to new places. It's time to get to the monarchy of Andorra. Let's go. This is it. It's do or die. Or as Nate likes to say, it's do or do. Because dying's not an option to him. As we come into this town, I'm at 999.9 miles of cycling. Done on this trip, here comes 1,000. We got snow on the mountains up ahead. Andorra is just beyond that ridge. Andorra, the town, is 18 kilometers. We have about 10 till we get to the country. Hey Nate, what does that sign say?
Andorra!
Woohoo!
Woohoo!
world record timing. So we hold a world record. Welcome to Andorra, Libya. I need to say that this is absolutely amazing. Nathan and I are on our way to find the L3 bus to take it up north a little bit to go check out some stuff that was recommended for us to see. So we have come to the town of Cornillo, and you see that little platform right there, about 1,000 feet directly above us? Well, that's why we came to this town, and the thing is, we didn't really realize what it was, and we found out that this is the road that goes up and around the mountain to take us to the top, and it's about 25 kilometers round trip, and that's a lot. However, we're not gonna walk the entirety of it, so we're gonna give it one shot to find someone driving up to it, maybe, which is very unlikely. But just maybe we'll get to the top. Dang it.
Help us.
Well, that didn't work out. It's okay though, I'm used to rejection, so I'm not really that upset. I'm just gonna wait for the bus now and go back, get something to eat, maybe McDonald's again.
Don't tell them that.
Nate, what time is it?
It's dinner time.
No. What time is it?
7:45.
Oh, that's... Hey, it's dinner time.
Hey!
Okay, so we're really in the mood to being served and being, like, waited on, okay?
That sounds really bad.
So we need to find some Andorran person that can speak English fluently that can help us out.
Who's about John's height and is a girl so that he can flirt with her.
Nope. We found some locals that are going to take us somewhere. We don't know where though. They just said follow us. So this could be good or bad. We have no idea. They don't even speak English that well. They don't even know I'm recording them. But let's see where they take us. Took us to Don Denis. And apparently there's a buffet
Don
here.
Denise.
Don
Denis.
What?
Denise.
It's Denise? Oh.
Not even worth it.
I think we're just gonna get kebab.
You shouldn't put this on video.
Why?
I don't want them to see if we can give it up on life.
Holy crap, dude, did you see the price of the cheeseburger? Nate, okay, yeah, we're eating here for sure. This is actually as white trash American as you can get it. Like, literally, I feel like we're in the Waffle House of Andorra, essentially. So we had Mexican food last night, and, well, we have this tonight. Say that was super successful. So we're gonna go to McDonald's now still and get some ice cream. Thank you. is it. That's the tunnel. This is the mountain. We're gonna be ascending to 8,000 feet. This is the pinnacle of our trip.
It's quite literally the peak.
It is the peak. Well, we're gonna be going up to almost 8,000 feet, like I just said.
So here we go.
And Nate's going off without me, because he's a good teammate. So. Coming up to the top, right up here. And at the top, nothing like name brand Milka ice cream for $4. Yeah, Nate already ate his, but speaking of Nate, he's gonna come over here and touch snow for the first time in the month of June. I mean, it's not really snow, it's really just ice. So before we go down the hill, I need to point out one thing. Right here used to be where my blue shoes were. And they're not there anymore because I accidentally left them at the bottom of the mountain. Because I set up the static shot that you saw just a couple minutes ago. So all I have now are these on my feet. Yay for the next 2 weeks. Oh, is this the border? You got me spinning now, you tie my hands and chain me down. When I can see you shut the door, and I'm alone, you ask for more. I'm so tired of this old game. So we just traveled 35 miles in the course of like an hour and a half. So we have arrived to our first French restaurant and we got cheeseburgers for 5 euros a piece while we're watching the FIFA game on TV as well. So not only did we get delectant food, but we also got a couch here for tonight. So we got cheap food and a free place to stay. And of course, to top off our first French day here, we got crepes. We got crepes.
We got crepes.
So we're gonna head on over to our couch surfer's place now. Here's the house. Here's the beautiful house. And they're outside right now eating dinner. So let's go outside.
Although you see some guys in Morocco and you know they're Berber.
Yeah.
They just look that bit.
So we're getting ready for bed now. I'm gonna sleep upstairs. Nate's gonna sleep right here. So Nathan, can you do the honors and transition us out?
Have a great day, guys.
At this point, I have lost track on what day on the road it actually is. We stopped at this patisserie and got some baked goods.
Looks really good.
Stopping in Aldi. First one in France. Google's taking us to some weird places. Google's taking us in some weird places again. I'm gonna have to have a discussion with her. Original town of Montreal, Canada. Carcassonne! And after cycling through nearly all of Carcassonne, we arrived at this place that looks very Americanized.
Nate got a taco. I got a cheeseburger again.
And we got McDonald's ice cream again, because we're Americans and we don't want anything else except McDonald's ice cream. But they don't have the dollar cones here this time. By the way, we got an Airbnb, in case you're wondering. So in order for Nathan and I to get to our Airbnb host, we actually have to cycle to the complete opposite side of town that we cycled through already, about 6 miles that direction. And we're exhausted and we don't want to do that, but we have to. So a few hours have passed and we've been in our Airbnb for a few hours. And it's actually nighttime and Nathan's brushing his teeth. And today was a very simple day and it was very basic. We did about 55, 60 miles and cycled all the way to the McDonald's on the other side of town and then cycled all the way back to this side of town to go to our Airbnb. Tomorrow we're going to explore a little bit of Carcassonne. I don't know if I'm going to
see the castle.
Yeah, see the castle. I don't know if I'm going to record or not. I guess you'll find out here in a few seconds. But if not, Narbona is our last cycling day together. Wait. No. Nathan might not join us, and he might...
I'm not joining you.
He's not going to join me. Wait, did we, just today, was today our last day we cycled together?
It was.
Oh.
Okay. Okay. That's enough.
So, I don't know what to do for this next week with you guys. In fact, I'm going through a lot of, like, struggles right now with logistics, with getting to the location that I need to get to, because my flight leaves out of Istanbul. I also want to spend some time in the Dolomites. I need to go to Nice. I want to go to Monaco. And I have so much that I need to get done in a short amount of time, especially with all of the stuff that I have, including my bike. I don't really know what I'm doing right now. So... bear with me over the next couple of minutes in this video while I try to figure that out. So, good night. You have no idea what I've gone through over the past 3 days. I am out here for my bags and my bike, waiting for a bus that takes me to Nice, assuming there actually is a bus, because it told me it was going to pick me up right here in 10 minutes. I was highly considering starting this video a week from now in the Dolomites or continuing it from there, but you guys just need to know what's going on. So I lost basically all the data for my Chapter 4 video, the one you're watching right now, and I'm pretty sure you heard this in the beginning of the video as well. Something went wrong when everything was in my laptop, and it literally just completely corrupted the whole SD card just out of nowhere. As you can imagine, I was very upset about that. And yesterday, I spent 6 hours at a bike shop trying to get this whole thing set up and ready, because I was expecting to ship it yesterday from here, but things went wrong with my credit cards and stuff like that, and so literally it was just a big cluster mess of a conglomerate of things that literally just made one of the worst days of my life. So it's really hard to explain, but I don't even know if this bus is gonna come, and I just want to get to Nice. I just want this bike to go, and that's basically where I am right now. I wish I could go into more detail about everything that's happened in the past 3 days, but it's just been a mess. And Nathan and I have split up now completely. We're done. We're together. And this video, I already know, has been very confusing, especially for those of you who didn't watch chapter 1, 2, or 3. So I apologize, but thank you for sticking in here with me, guys. I'm ready to go home, but I still got 10 more days. Top of my phone being stolen, I barely have my laptop, and it's already 7 minutes past the departure time of the bus, and I've been sitting here for 45 minutes, and there's no bus. I'm a little confused as to what's going on exactly, just as you are. So I just sat here for an hour waiting for a bus that never showed up. I'm left with only one option. Go to the train station behind me and buy a $100 ticket to Nice. And the hardest part is trying to figure out how to get all this by myself to that building. Okay, let's get off this blasted train. Great. Now I have to figure out what to do with all this stuff. Bring it over there. I got all my crap on the train, the Nice. Oh my gosh. No, that's actually my bike. I wish my bike looked like that, but it actually looks like that. I got all my crap here in Nice. With the help of random strangers, and thank the Lord, one of them was American. So now I gotta transport all this to my hostel, which is like literally right there. I've actually been standing here for almost half an hour trying to figure out what to do because the taxis are $25 and they won't go lower than $20. And literally, I just need to go 3 blocks away because they said it's a charge fee for all the stuff, which I understand, but like, I'm not about to pay a full day's meal wage to transport my crap 3 blocks when I just went 300 miles. Well, I gave into the taxi and I spent 20 euros to travel 3 blocks, but I made it. I made it.
If only you could feel exactly what I'm going through right now. I also haven't eaten all day. It's even harder doing this without a phone. I also formatted my SD card that I put all of the recovered video files for this video on. Good thing is, I didn't format the other one. The one that actually has the corrupted files, so I'm gonna have to recover them all over again. Thank you guys for sticking in here with me. You know, I gotta tell you, being in Monaco right now is really growing on me. All these million-dollar yachts everywhere. Cars, the weather, and this ice cream. I almost wish you were with me right now, but I don't. Because I'm really enjoying this by myself. Chances are, if you made it this far in the video, you are probably very confused, as much as I am, because I don't even know what I'm doing now at this point in terms of this chapter. Now, if I could pick any boat in this entire lot, I'd pick that one right there. That's mine. Now, honestly, this type of boat right here, this, wow, just look at this. That pool is so freaking blue. I wonder if it's because of all the pee. Over the course of the past 3 days, Nathan and I have been deciding about exactly when to split up and when not to split up. And we thought Foix was our second to last day, but Foix to Carcassonne ended up being our last day, and that kind of threw us for a loop. I thought I was gonna go up to the Dolomites and photograph, but I decided not to do that because renting a car was gonna cost me 400 euros. What I decided to do instead was go straight to Slovenia, where I'm going to meet a friend, but before I do that, go to Venice. So tomorrow morning I leave and go to Venice. On another note, something's definitely going down here in this area. So let's go see what's up. This looks like my kind of area. Reminds me of Ohio. I picked up some jam for home. Just asked the guard where I need to go to get to the train station, and you know what he said?
You said back down the exact same way it just came, all the way to the freaking bottom to go all the way back up top. So I think I have found Monaco's reoccurring theme, and it's pick a flight of stairs, go up it, and hope you've reached the right destination. This reminds me of the Adirondacks. So after walking up all these stairs, I went to a market store and I got a couple of things for my mom. But that's not the point. The point is, I asked the lady, hey, where's the train station? And she just spent the past 10 minutes bringing me this direction, which is right at the top of the stairs I just came up 10 minutes ago. So she told me to go this direction and eventually I'll make it to the train station. I think these are what she might have been talking about. Finally made it. The train doesn't come for 45 minutes. It's normally every 20 minutes, but France is on a strike. So let's wait.
Tschüss, auf Wiedersehen.
And we are back in Nice.
Alright, so it's like 11 p.m. now and I got a big day ahead of me and I don't even know how I'm gonna wake up. So I'm going to Venice. And I'm also trying to figure out when to end this video.
I want you to know I've had to carry this 40-pound duffel bag on my back for the past 6 hours. Well, I took trains that were also very confusing. But guess what? We made it to Venice, baby. Other than the fact that I can't feel my arms because the blood circulation has been cut off, I feel great. I feel really good. Now that I've removed myself from the main island of Venice over there, I gotta find that hostel now though, but I don't actually remember what the name of it is. You should think I found it right here. Would you look at that? Here we are, just you and me, at the end of chapter 4 and what is probably the end of the beginning. That probably didn't make any sense, but this is the end of chapter 4, guys, and in fact, this is actually the end of the entire series. We started in Lisbon and spent the past 1,600 miles cycling. It wasn't 3,000 miles and it wasn't everything we thought it was going to be in terms of what we were going to be able to do, because we planned way too much for what was going to happen. And so in chapter 1 we decided to cut it short, because obviously 3,000 miles and the allotted amount of time that we actually had was way too much to do. And then in chapter 2 you got to see exactly what the suffering was like for my leg and everything, but then chapter 3 you got to see the rehabilitation and the comeback. And here is the end, and you could see. And the fact that I've lost most of the footage from chapter 4 and all of this has just been pretty interesting to see how it plays out, but I've learned so much and I've grown so much. So thank you so much for watching, guys. I'm here in Venice, Italy. I'm gonna journey to Slovenia the day after tomorrow and check out the Eastern Europe countries, and then fly out of Istanbul, have a layover in Ukraine, and then head home for Jason's wedding. That's my friend. So this might be the end of chapter 4. However, it's definitely not the end of my videos, guys. I have so much more cool stuff and fun stuff coming up. So hit that subscribe button if you're not already subscribed, and I normally never say that, but do it. So like I said, this is the end of the beginning, guys. Thank you for sticking in there. For those of you who watched every single one of the chapters, you just watched 2 hours of videos of mine. That's a waste of your life. I'm just kidding. Totally kidding. I don't really know why I just said that. But anyways, thank you. From the bottom of my heart. Chapter 4, and the trip, and the end of Europe 2018. I bid you farewell. Until next time, guys. I'm Jonathan Zaharik. See you later. Praises of a thousand generations, you are Lord of all. And unto you, the slain and risen King, we lift our voice with heaven, singing, worthy, Lord of all. Lord.